Yes, I feel that, you know, if I perform and do very well in the exhibition season, I have definitely have a very good chance of being the Dallas Cowboys starting quarterback. Again, it's based on performance and, you know, earning that job, but I am very optimistic that at least I'll have the chance in training camp and also during the exhibition season to prove that I can be a starting quarterback, and I think if I got the chance to start like I did last year, that I wouldn't lose that job.
Well, you know, I don't obviously don't want to put you on the spot in terms of contradicting what Coach Landry did, but do you really feel as though you did have the fair shot? It would appear as though you might have been pulled in that St. Louis game a little bit prematurely last year.
No, there's no question about it. In Coach Landry's mind, in my second year, that, you know, I wasn't ready to be a starting quarterback due to probably experience and knowledge of the game. And of course, he's extremely successful and is a tremendous coach, and he knows, you know, I guess more than any of us do. And I wasn't ready in his mind last year, and I can kind of understand this. And again, the past is the past, and I'm looking forward to this year. And I think it's in his mind, if I, you know, perform and earn the job and work very hard, that at least I have another year of knowledge now and I can be a starting quarterback.
Been getting to look pretty much now, what do you look like?
Quite a bit, still a little young.
But the general face, the hair, the tone of the hair.
The features are all there.
Yeah, I can make it.
I think the coloration probably.
Yeah.
Probably a little more toward the center here, too.
A little more to the center.
Yeah, it's pretty wide. It's about that wide. Heavier toward the front and taper in toward the back.
After Friday, this South Dallas Community Center will no longer serve the community. The Presbytery of Northeast Texas is closing the center because it says it does not fulfill the purposes established by the church. However, the assistant director of the center, Fred Bell, spent all night in the building to keep the church from removing the furniture. He explained to me what he thought the purpose of the center was.
I feel like everyone has a right to their own religion, and it's certainly not religious. It could have been more recreational facilities, but they wouldn't provide, and the bill is not even facilitated for that. We're doing a whole lot of political work in the community, and trying to bring about some political awareness, because I believe that all of our social ills, you know, and habits assumed by the people is due to an environment, you know, it's created by, you know, economical, political oppression.
So what are you going to do?
We're going to do just what we're doing now, continue to operate the center, pending negotiation with the board. Not even negotiation. We're going to submit this, and it'll be up to them for the next move.
Well, can you? It's mainly because you brought politics into the church, and the church disagreed with this. Do you think that's the essence of the whole problem?
I think white racism is the essence of the whole problem.
The tired phrase, let's reorder priorities, is one that's been around for years. This is not something aimed at this particular administration. It's not political. When the National Urban Coalition was founded in 1967, we issued a call at that time. I wasn't then involved with it, but those who founded the organization issued a call for new priorities, and that was under the Johnson administration. The Johnson administration endorsed this call. The Nixon administration has endorsed the call. It has become part of the rhetoric of our public debate to talk about the need to reorder our priorities. Whenever a thing doesn't get done, or whenever everyone sees a need to be met, that's the phrase we brandish about, reorder priorities.
And if we're ever to move to the kind of meaningful role that we in regional government must play, it will come only through greater public understanding of our purpose and the need for it. They must understand that there are problems that extend beyond our individual city boundaries that can be dealt with only when we work in a cooperative fashion to deal with them. We will achieve the kind of power that we need to do these jobs only when the public understands the need for them and gives us the kind of support that we need to get our state legislatures, to get our cities and our counties to respond to this particular need.
Your recent return to Dallas, still hope that you might be able to play here?
Well, I think the team wanted me to play from what I hear, and I think in a way the management wanted me to play, but I think considering all the factors, perhaps it just wasn't in the cards. I don't know how else to put it. It's just one of those things, and sometimes it's best to clean the slate and start over anew. And again, you can second guess till kingdoms come, and you never will know for sure exactly what was what had you done it a different way. And as I say, the only thing to do is to go out and do the best job you can, and that's what I want to do. And I'm sure the Cowboys actually, they're probably better off than they were. They're getting an excellent receiver in Lance Allworth. I have the highest respect for him. He stepped right into my jersey. He wears the same number.
That's got to hurt a little bit.
Well, that hurts. Yeah, it does. Except that I respect him a lot as an athlete and as a man, and I know that he probably deserves to wear it more than I did.
Now, come on.
Well, that's not instant humble. I mean, I just respect him a lot as a ball player, and that's what I meant by that. And I think the Cowboys certainly got two fine ends and three fine ends in Tucker and Billy Truex and, of course, Lance, and I know that they're just going to have a super team.
We wish you the best.
Well, I thank you for that, and I'd like to thank all the people such as you and Bob St. John and Steve Perkins, Blackie Sherrod, and others, and all the people in Dallas and throughout the country who supported me. I've had a good chance to see the good and bad sides of human nature in my certain situation, and I've appreciated the very many people who supported me, and I hope that I can repay them by having the best year I can possible to support their faith in me, and I hope it works out that way. And I wish my team, who I feel great feelings for, the best of luck.
I don't think they would be expected to support it any more than the people who threw the sewing machines out of the windows during the French Revolution, who said we can't have progress because sewing machines replaced the women who sew by hand.
After the people turned down the constitutional amendment, and justly so, in my opinion, it's obvious that we have to pass either Nugent's House bill or the House has to pass my Senate bill 86 in order to have an ethics bill come out of this session of the legislature.
Senator McCool, does this mean that you did find some questionable practices?
Well, we pointed out in the findings which preceded our recommendation that there were instances where there were no written orders or instructions from the Board of Regents. There were, in fact, there was a two-year period where the Board of Regents gave no resolutions of any type. There were instances where the Deputy Chancellor of the University and Mr. Frank Irwin, the former chairman himself, said that if they had to do it over again, they wouldn't do it in this manner.
the first time Dallas County voters have disagreed with other Texans. Dallasites approved all four constitutional amendments, but the rest of the state felt only the water quality bonds, amendment number 4, was worth passing. The voice of the voter was unanimous, though, in saying yes to liquor by the drink. Votes ranged from 18-4 and 15 against in Loving County to 139,000 yeses and 40,000 noes in Houston's Harris County. Dallas approved that measure, 37,000 to 12,000, with only 15 of the more than 300 voting precincts turning down the shot glass. 13 of those precincts voting no were in dry areas. The next step now is to get licenses issued. Official results of the election are being tabulated now and should be in shape for county commissioners to certify them at the regular meeting tomorrow morning. After that, applicants must advertise 2 days in a newspaper and take that application along with their $2,000 fee to the local Alcoholic Beverage Commission office. If the investigation turns up no reason to deny the permit, the application will go to Austin for approval. Officials in Dallas say they expect a run of 100 or more applications beginning next week, the earliest any could come to the Dallas office. While Dallas voters were approving most of the amendments, Fort Worth more went along with the rest of the state. Here's Jerry Park with that story.
As goes Tarrant County, so goes the state. Here yesterday's electors put the stamp of rejection on the first three proposed constitutional amendments, but gave the nod to the Clean Water Amendment. In the five Justice of the Peace precincts voting on liquor by the drink, the voters approved the measure in every one. The original estimate of 30,000 voters was surpassed substantially. Over 48,000 ballots were cast. One interesting note, of the 48,000 votes cast, 42,000 of those came from the 98 polling places where liquor by the drink was on the ballot, and only 6,000 votes were cast in the dry areas.
When you say, is there a limit on public obligation? I think we've got to find a way in this country to permit every human being to live a decent life. During the campaign, President Nixon said, if this country is not good enough for any of us, it's not good enough for all of us. And the fact is that somehow we've got to find a way to assure that people who are living lives of desperation, degradation, poverty in this country, are given a chance to live with decency.
Putting was real good. I just got a lot of good breaks. I've had some good breaks the past 4 weeks and been putting pretty well. And last week, just I feel like I couldn't do any wrong out there on the golf course.
Lee Trevino has quite a few comments about your putting grip. Where did you get a putting grip with your hands so wide apart?
I really don't know. I didn't know it was that unorthodox until someone told me about it. It just felt the way it felt natural to me, and that's what I've been doing it for quite a while.
I think you made the comment that if you got over on a slow green, you'd hit the ball twice before you get away from it.
Well, when I get on slow greens, I must change my putter to go to one a little heavier because the one I have is too light, so I imagine that may be true.
Have you played this course yet?
I played 9 holes yesterday, and I will not tell you what I shot. It wasn't very good.
What do you think it's going to take to win this tournament?
Oh, I have no idea. I hadn't been on the tour long enough to start predicting scores like that. And I'm sure 4 or 5 under par would be a great score here. Even par, I'd take even par right now and be happy as can be.
Anticipate being out of business within 2 years, or for that matter, within a good number of years. I think it's entirely likely that we will see the enactment of some measure in the nature of a national health insurance program. But the kind of program that will evolve is, at this point in time, very much undecided.
Could a governmental agency put together a program similar to Blue Cross Blue Shield and make it work?
It seems to me that this would be virtually impossible, at least as an overnight thing.
We said in order to reorder priorities, you've got to talk in terms of the budget, which indicates what you're going to do with the available resources. We can use all the rhetoric we want, but until we make it concrete in terms of how much money have we got and how are we going to use it, it simply is going to be, again, platitudinous. So we undertook in the period of a year to put people to work in order to get specifics on how we might use our resources differently. And I want to call your attention to the fact